ओम अज्ञानतिमिरांधस्य ज्ञानांजनशलाकय चक्षुरुन्मीलितं येन तस्मै श्रीगुरवे नमः।
श्रीचैतन्यमनोभीष्टं स्थापितं येन भूतले
स्वयं रूपः कदा मह्यं ददाति स्वपदान्तिकं। नमा ओं विष्णुपादाय कृष्णप्रेष्ठाय भूतले श्रीमते भक्तिवेदान्तस्वामिन् इति नामिने। नमस्ते सारस्वतदेव गौरवाणी प्रचारिणे निर्विशेष शून्यवादी पाश्चात्यदेशतारिणे। जय श्री प्रभु नित्यानंद
श्री अद्वैत गदाधर श्रीवासादि गौर भक्तवृंद।
हरे कृष्णा 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 हरे हरे, हरे राम हरे राम राम राम। हरे कृष्णा। जस्ट मेकिंग श्योर दैट
हरे कृष्णा
जस्ट मेकिंग श्योर दैट आई एम सिटिंग ओके बिकॉज आई हैव टू बी हियर फॉर एटलीस्ट वन आवर। The indirect message was the class is going to be more than 1 hour. So thank you all for coming this evening. My special gratitude to the hosts for kindly opening the doors, not just of the house but of the heart, to let all the devotees walk in for nice Hari Katha and Hari Kirtan. In Sanskrit, the house is called Bhavan. The house is called Bhavan, where the first syllable is Bha, which stands for Bhagavan. So that place where everybody stays together under one roof and the first priority is given to the Supreme Lord is called Bhavan. And that house where Bhagavan, Sri Krishna, has no place is not Bhavan, but the Bha is out. So what is left? And what do you mean by one? And who lives there?
Animals.
Thank you. For a change, I'm the audience and I'm listening. So it's so wonderful that all of us are having not one but Bhavan, because we're having houses where as family we're all staying together and keeping Krishna as the priority. Now you may ask me, what is the proof that Krishna is the priority in your life? The simple proof that on a weekday evening, so many devotees are assembled. You have your work, you have children, and so many things to do, but yet you gave this time of your week, this time of your day, for Krishna Kirtan and Krishna Katha. ब्रह्मण कृष्ण कथा पुण्य माधवे लोकमलापः कोण तृप्येत श्रुण्वाण श्रुतज्ञ नित्य नूतन। दिस कृष्ण कथा इज पुण्य प्यूरिफाइंग। वासुदेव कथा प्रश्न पुरुषं त्रीं पुनातिहि वक्तारं प्रचकं श्रोत्रं यत्पादं सलिलं यथा। दिस कृष्ण कथा प्यूरिफाइज थ्री काइंड्स ऑफ पीपल। वासुदेव कथा प्रश्न, दिस वासुदेव कथा, वासुदेव इज द सन ऑफ वसुदेव महाराज विच मीन्स कृष्ण। पुरुषं त्रीं पुनाति, पुनाति मीन्स टू प्यूरिफाई, द वर्ड पूत मीन्स प्यूरिफिकेशन एंड ना मीन्स नो। She who has no purity is Puta Na. Puta Na. So Punati or Puta means purity. Purusham, personalities. Trim, three. Purusham Trim Punati. Three kinds of people are uplifted and purified. Vaktaram Prachakam Shrotram. Vakta, which means the speaker. Prachakam. Those who ask questions. So if you think asking questions is wrong, No, absolutely no. It is the right thing to do because you're second on the list of purification. And the third is Shrotram, those who hear but don't have questions. So hearing about Krishna, speaking about Krishna, and after hearing, pondering and having questions. These three kinds of people get purified. And what is the example? Yat padam salilam yatha. Just like Ganga flows. The place where Ganga originates, Gangotri, Gomukh, is pure. The place where Ganga flows through, all those places are pure. And the place where Ganga meets the ocean, or the ultimate destination, is also pure. So the source, the destination, and path in the middle, all get purified. Similarly, Harikatha, wherever it emanates, which means the speaker, wherever it goes, which means the listener, and in the middle, those who are listening and having questions. All three get purified. So this Krishna Katha is Punya and Madhavi, sweet. Generally, medicines are not so sweet. Therefore, parents have to trick their children. They have pills which are bitter. And what do? They mix it up in a sweet juice and give the juice. And the child is drinking the juice and in goes the pill. Because the pill is bitter, or the syrup is bitter, or the medicine is bitter. But this medicine, Bhavaushada Shrotra Manovhirama, Canto 10, Chapter 1, Text 4, Srimad Bhagavatam. This medicine to remove repeated birth and death must be so bitter. Is it not? One medicine which has to purify us of cough and cold is so bitter. Or fever is so bitter. What to speak of the medicine to purify us and remove the fever of repeated birth and death? It has to be so bitter. But interestingly, Madhvi, it is the sweetest. Madhuram madhure bhyope, mangale bhyope mangalam, pavanam pavane bhyope, hare namaiva kevalam. Madhuram madhure bhyope, mangale bhyope mangalam. Krishna Naam and Krishna Katha are most purifying. Sweet, sweetest among all sweet things. Most auspicious among all auspicious things. Which means, yajnas are auspicious, giving charity is auspicious, vrata, tapa, dan, all auspicious, swadhyay, all auspicious. But, if you want to do the most auspicious thing, engage in Krishna Katha and Krishna Kirtan. Pavane, pavanam pavane bhyopi. Of all the processes to purify the self, the process of hearing and chanting about Krishna is the fastest, surest, quickest. Yet simple and easy for everyone. No qualification, no disqualification. Anyone, anywhere, anyhow, anytime can chant and remember. One person, he was always preached to by different sadhus, but he would never chant Harinam. So Narada Muni, the king of all preachers, went there. And he said, please chant the name of Krishna. He said, I have no time. Oh, please hear about Krishna. Oh, I have no time. Then Narada Muni, being a strategic preacher, he scratched his head. And he said, do you bathe every day? He said, yes, I do. He said, how much time do you bathe? He said, it takes about 10-15 minutes overall. He said, good. That 10-15 minutes, chant the name of Sri Ram. You can chant the name of Sri Ram anywhere. Please chant. So he said, really? I can chant the all-powerful, all-auspicious, all-sweet, all-beneficial name in the washroom? In a bathroom? He said, yes, you can. And he started bathing. And with so much ecstasy, he would chant the name of Sri Ram. And wherever the names of Sri Ram are chanted, Hanuman manifests. So Hanuman appeared there. And he said, the names of Sri Ram are being chanted here. Where is it? He went into the kitchen, couldn't find anyone. Living room, couldn't find anyone. Bedroom, couldn't find anyone. Went into different places, couldn't find anyone. Garage, couldn't find anyone. Lawn, couldn't find anyone. And then finally he went to the washroom. stuck his ear. And he could hear Ram Naam Uccharanam, the vibration of chanting Ram Naam coming inside, from inside. So he's saying, this rascal is chanting the name of Sri Ram in an impure place. Let him come out. I'm going to teach him a lesson. And now you know what Hanuman can do with his fist when he could burn the whole city of Lanka with his tail. Hanuman is such a servant of the Lord that even when his body is on fire, he thinks of how to use that fire in the service of the Lord. That is Hanuman. Dasya Bhava in and out, completely. So this devotee chanting Ram Naam came out, so blissful. He didn't know what was coming up. So Hanuman warmed up a bit. And this person came out, punched him on his cheek. Swole up like a balloon. Hanuman said, this is what you need. You're offending the holy name. Then he felt very nice that he punished the miscreant. Went flying into Ayodhya. And Sri Ram was sitting in a pondering mood. So Hanuman asked him, my lord, what are you thinking about? Sri Ram said, he took his hand out and said, some monkeys hit me and slapped me on the face, and look, my face has become like a balloon. He said, who did that? Ram said, you. Hanuman said, no, my lord, this is the first time I'm seeing you today. I didn't hit you. Ram said, did you hit anyone? Yes, there was one miscreant who was chanting your name in a very impure place. Sri Ram said, these holy names are so pure that they don't get contaminated by being chanted in a contaminated place. In fact, wherever they are chanted, that place becomes a dham. There is no consideration for chanting Harinam and Sri Ram Naam, and can be chanted and must be chanted at all times. Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, when he went to the restroom, he would hold his tongue. So a young child by the name Gopal, he asked Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, why are you holding your tongue like this when you go to the washroom? Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu said, what to do? I'm so used to chanting Harinam, the names of Sri Krishna, that even when I go to an impure place, my tongue vibrates. And I know it's offensive. I shouldn't be chanting. Therefore, I'm holding my tongue. So this Gopal, he called Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu out. And he said, my lord, you know everything. But still you're giving me an opportunity to preach. And therefore I want to make a point. Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu would do this time and again. He would ask Ramananda Rai on the banks of Godavari to explain all the different intricacies of bhakti. And Ramananda Rai would say, Tumi vakta prabhu tumi shrota. You are asking this question. And you as Paramatma is answering through me, and that answer you are listening. My lord, when there is a musical concert, the musician is playing the violin and the musical instruments. The sound is coming from the instrument, but who's playing it? The musician. So it seems in this concert, I am the instrument through whose strings different musical ragas are manifesting. But you're the musician who's playing it. I'm the string instrument and you're the musician. So Gopal taught Chaitanya Mahaprabhu that, my lord, the holy name is so pure that it has no consideration. Tatra arpita niyamita smaranena kalaha. There is no consideration of time, place and circumstance. The holy name must be chanted at all times by everyone under all circumstances, without any consideration of time, place, circumstance, auspicious or inauspicious, favorable, unfavorable, pure, impure. All the time, the holy name must be chanted. And Chaitanya Mahaprabhu felt so jubilant. He kept Gopal on his lap and he said, you are my spiritual master. You are Guru. So your name is not Gopal, but from today you are called Gopal Guru. And later on he became a very great Goswami. So his name became Gopal Guru Goswami. So the principle is the holy name must be chanted at all times. Katha, Krishna Katha must be spoken and heard at all times. Varjanam bhava bijanam arjanam sukha sampadam tarjanam yamadutanam rama rameti garjanam. Varjanam bhava bijanam. Bhava means repeated birth and death, which means suffering. Bija means seed. So bhava bija means seed of suffering. Varjanam means to roast. What happens when you roast a seed? It won't fructify. If you roast a seed, it won't fructify. So the conditions given are, the first line says, the seed of repeated birth and death, the seed of suffering gets roasted. What does that mean? No more repeated birth and death, no more suffering. And second line, arjanam sukha sampadam. Not just that the seed gets roasted, the seed of suffering gets roasted, but arjanam, arjanam means to collect. Sukha sampadam arjanam. The living entity doesn't just escape suffering, but keeps collecting lots of happiness while being in this body. So that's very inspiring. You become supremely happy and the seed of suffering gets roasted. Who sang this? Valmiki sang this. Varjanam bhava bijanam arjanam sukha sampadam. The seed of repeated birth and death and suffering are roasted once and for all. And a living entity, and that living entity also collects abundant happiness. And after death, tarjanam yamadutanam. Tarjanam means to shoo away. If yamadutas are coming, they see you and they run in the opposite direction. Their GPS starts rerouting. Varjanam bhava bijanam. Suffering gone. Arjanam sukha sampadam. Happiness collected. Tarjanam yamadutanam. And yamadutas are shooed away. For whom? Rama Rama iti garjanam. Anyone who thunders the holy name of Sri Ram, for such a person, all three things are possible. This Hare Krishna Mahamantra, every time it is chanted, has four rams. Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, 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 Hare Hare. So Madhvi, sweet, this katha is sweet. And Lokam Malapaha, we just described how the suffering and all the contamination is removed. Therefore, the question asked is, Kona Tripyeta Shrunmana? Who is that person who will listen to all this and feel satisfied? Enough, I've heard enough, I'm feeling happy. No, after hearing Harikatha, the feeling of being thirsty and dissatisfied increases. Previously, we're thirsty for Harikatha. But once you start tasting Harikatha, the heart wants more. You can't be satisfied. Even after 2 hours of Harikatha, we want more. Because Nitya Nutana, it's always fresh. So this beautiful story of Hanumanji is very instructive. Because the holy name was offended at that point by restriction on the basis of time, place and circumstance. So who got the hit on the face? Sri Ram. Because Sri Ram Nam and Sri Ram are non-different. Nam and Nami are non-different. Hanumanji serves in so many wonderful ways. In Jagannath Puri, there is a very beautiful deity of Kanfata Hanuman. You have seen this deity? Anybody has been to this deity? Kanfata Hanuman? That's the connection to our topic. Jagannath Leela. So, this is a very tall deity of Hanumanji in Jagannath Puri. So one time, Prabhu Jagannath, along with Subhadra Devi, and Baladev Prabhu were on the altar. All three are standing like this. So the ocean was making a lot of noise. The waves of the ocean were hitting the shore and a lot of noise. The ocean, in the base of the ocean, there are pearls. And pearls represent Lakshmi. And Lakshmi is the consort of Jagannath. The ocean is protecting Lakshmi, which means he is the father. Therefore, the ocean to Jagannath is father-in-law. So when there was a lot of sound, noise, Baldev Prabhu looked at Jagannath and he said, your father-in-law is talking a lot today. He's making a lot of noise. So Jagannath started trembling, know what to do. Baladev Prabhu said, are you going to talk to your father-in-law or should I go? So Jagannath said, no, you calm down, I will go. You don't worry, I will go and talk to my father-in-law. So Jagannath feared if Baladev Prabhu went and spoke to his father-in-law, end of his relationship with Lakshmi. Because Baldev Prabhu is a very fiery person. So Jagannath said, don't worry, I'll go and talk to my father-in-law, the ocean. But now he feared, how would he go and do that? But still he mustered some courage and he went and dear ocean, seems like you're singing very melodiously today. Very nice. A little loud also today. Yeah, very, very nice, but having a nice time. Jagannath was beating around the bush a bit because he was fearing, he didn't know how to put it. So his father-in-law, so what is the point? What are you talking about? Jagannath said, volume little? You can reduce a little. Very nice, very, very melodious. I'm enjoying. But little, if you can reduce. So the ocean said, one day I'm singing that, you have a problem. Jagannath said, okay, no problem. You sing. He was coming back. Thought, what to do? Came to the temple. Baldev Prabhu was there. What is the news? He said he will, sing little. He said the sound will be reduced, don't worry. Baldev Prabhu said, good. Waiting, 5 minutes, 10 minutes, 15 minutes, 20 minutes, still the sound is on. He looked at Jagannath and he said, whom did you go and say? Ocean, right? He said, yes, I went and told the ocean. Then, don't worry, let me try again. So Jagannath left. This time he thought, let me go and talk to Lakshmi Devi. She, through her, I can speak. Went to Lakshmi Devi and he said, your father is singing very nicely today, very, very melodious. But just today, little, I think on the mic he's singing, right? You can reduce the volume a little. Lakshmi got frantic. One day my father is singing, that also you have a problem. What has he done to you? Why is everybody laughing? Something familiar? He can relate to it. One brahmachari in Radha Gopina temple was saying, there are three kinds of living entities in this world. Sur, Asur and Sasur. Beware of all three. But in a light-hearted way. Nothing against the father-in-laws here. It's just in a humorous way. So he went and told Lakshmi, and Lakshmi was getting angry and frantic. Now Jagannath was stuck between his wife, father-in-law and his brother. So don't worry, even the Lord of the universe has this problem. We are following paramparas. So Jagannath is thinking, now what to do? I have to call one servant of mine who has no idea of Grihastashram, who is blissful. He remembers Hanuman. When Hanuman arrives, Jagannath looks at him and says, just be like this. Just stay a brahmachari. Don't. Be as you are. So Hanuman was very happy. He said, "My Lord, how can I serve you?" Jagannath opened his heart and he said, "This is the predicament, this is the problem." Hanuman said, "No problem, my Lord. I can help you." Hanuman expanded in size and opened up his ears and absorbed all the sound of the ocean into his ears. So Kan Fata means, Kan means ear. So that Hanuman who stands like this, absorbing all the sound of the ocean into his ear, is Kan Fata Hanuman. The amazing mystery, even till this date, is the fact that when you're outside the Jagannath temple, you can hear the ocean. You enter one step into, you can't. You enter the temple, you cannot hear the sound of the ocean. You come out and then you can hear. Why? Kan Fata Hanuman. Kan Fata Hanuman. So Jagannath and Hanuman have many things in common like this. Many, many sweet pastimes together. There's another very beautiful story. So, just to wrap up the previous one. Whenever you happen to go to Jagannath Puri, you have to see Kan Fata Hanuman and offer a special prayer for me. Yeah? Yes or no?
Yes!
Let's have the attitude of gratitude. Jagannath Swami Ki!
Yeah!
Now we know Jagannath also has another few more pastimes with Hanuman. I want to narrate one more. For about 1 or 2 weeks after Snanyatra is the day when Jagannath takes a public bath. He goes into the ocean and he has an ocean bath. Everybody bathes in there. He is Lord of the universe, so everything is public. So he goes into the ocean. And he takes his ocean bath. This is Snanyatra. And then the time after that is called Anavasar, which means Jagannath falls ill. He becomes sick. For those who are from Odisha, will have idea of this. Jagannath is sick. The temple is closed, shut. Nobody can see for 15 days. And at that time, the body of the Lord temperature increases. And they give him medicine on a special tube from the side. And all the medicine goes into the mouth. And the temperature of the deity increases. And he's very sick. And during the year, he's served by Brahmanas. But during those 15 days, he's served by a caste called Daitapati. They are lower than Shudra. That caste is a very low caste. But interestingly, those 15 days, only Daitapatis will serve, no Brahmana. If you're Brahmana, it's disqualification, you're out. Only Daitapati. Now, when you're not sick, Your colleagues take care of you and your friends take care of you. But when you're sick, who takes care of you? Your family. So Jagannath is the Lord of the universe who has no discrimination with anyone on the basis of caste, creed, religion, nationality, body, anything. So therefore, when he is hale and hearty, he takes service from the Brahmanas. But when he's sick, he takes service from the low class. Showing the fact that actually they are dear to me. I am equally disposed of to everyone. I have equal relationship with everyone. I am the Lord of the universe. Jagannath is a very sweet person, you know, Lord. These Daitapatis have no fixed vidhi or rules of even offering prasad, bhoga to Jagannath. You know how they offer bhoga to Jagannath? How we offer bhoga to Jagannath? To the Lord. We cannot smell, we cannot taste. Of course, we can see, otherwise how you'll cook. You can smell, you can taste, but then you have to offer with proper vidhi. And give 15-20 minutes for the Lord. And then ring the bell, knock the door, enter, bow down and take. That is prasad. But Daitapati, how they offer to Jagannath? They make Jagannath's plate, and in front of Jagannath's plate, they make their plate. And they tell Jagannath, you eat. And they also eat in the temple room with him. Jagannath is eating and they are also eating. Jagannath enjoys. Of course, we cannot imitate all this. This is just good to hear and understand the greatness of Jagannath's mercy. So they cook all of this and offer it to Jagannath, and they're also eating, and they say, yes, you also eat, come on. Friends sit together and eat, like that. And during Rath Yatra, sometimes he's pulled, sometimes he's pushed. This is the only Lord who takes all of this. Sometimes when he doesn't move, with ropes he's pulled. Sometimes he's pulled up with ropes. No other Lord allows all this. But Prabhu Jagannath, because he's the Lord of the universe, he allows everything. In fact, on one certain day, in Jagannath Puri, any person can go and even embrace Jagannath. The deity of the Lord can be embraced. And your desire can be expressed and it will be fulfilled. I know one devotee in Mumbai who was not having a child for over 10 years after marriage. And he took advantage of this principle. He said, I shouldn't ask material desires, any inclinations. I shouldn't have and shouldn't express that to the Lord. But akama sarvakamo va moksha kama udaradi tivrena bhakti yogena yajeta purusham param. Canto 2, chapter 3, text 10, Srimad Bhagavatam. He said, I have material desires. If I don't go to Jagannath, whom will I go to? I don't want to go to any demigods. Kama istaisairata jnana prapadyanti anya devata. Antavattu falam tesham tadbhavati alpamevasa. I don't want to approach the demigods, but I want to approach Jagannath. So he went and embraced Jagannath. And that very year, his wife became pregnant and gave birth to a very beautiful son. And they named him Neel Madhav, which is the name of Jagannath. So very unique Lord. You can do so many things with him. So this supremely beautiful and sweet Jagannath falls ill during Anavasar. So one Alvar, the Alvars, the 12 Alvars from South India are saints in the Sri Sampradaya. So one of the Alvars walked all the way to Jagannath Puri to take darshan. And the Pandas, the Pujaris said, you can't have darshan for 2 weeks. He said, Baba, I have walked hundreds and thousands of kilometers. Please open, let me see Jagannath. He said, impossible, come after 15 days. He's sick. This Alvar's jaw almost hit the ground in disbelief. He said, that is Narayan. It is the Supreme Lord who cures our sickness of repeated birth and death. And you say, he's sick? Enough, open. He said, hey, we are really, he just took his medicine. He's resting now, you come out later. So this Alvar, he didn't know what to do. He told them, I have walked all the way just to see my Lord. If you don't let me see Jagannath, I will go into the ocean and commit suicide. The Panda said, okay, if that is what you wanted to go, do. But the Lord will not give darshan. So he gave Dandavat and he left towards the ocean. Now our Jagannath, his heart is very soft. Prabhu Jagannath's heart is very soft. Jagannath Dev. Jagannath Dev couldn't be sick and see his pure devotee go commit suicide because the devotee had so much nishtha, so much determination. If I don't see my Lord face to face, I am ending my life. No need of having these peacock plume, you know, plumes on the peacock feather. You have eyes on the peacock feather, but they don't see. So what is the use of having my eyes which are like plumes on the peacock feather? Who can see the Lord? So I'm committing suicide. But our Jagannath Dev's heart is like butter. Very soft. Little heat and it melts. Santa Ridaya Navanita Samana Kaha Kavi Par Kahin Bijana. It is said the heart of the devotees is also like butter. Why? Because Krishna steals butter. Why does Krishna steal butter? Because butter has two qualities. One, it is white. Second, it is soft. So when the devotee's heart becomes white in purity and soft in compassion, that's when the butter thief comes and steals the heart. So the heart of the devotees are considered to be butter. But great acharyas have written, Santa Hridaya Navanita Samana, that the heart of the devotees are compared to butter. But this is a wrong example. Why? Because when you heat butter, what happens? It melts. But devotee's heart when you torture them, they don't get affected. But if you torture someone else, they get affected. Butter gets affected when the heat is high. Is it not? You increase, melts. So for the devotee, if you increase distress in his life, he doesn't melt in the sense that he is not affected by any heat or cold in this world. He is always absorbed. But if someone else is having distress in their life, his heart melts. Not when he is having distress. So devotee says that it is said that the heart of the devotee is like butter. But it is a wrong explanation. Because butter, when it is heated, it is affected. But devotees are never affected by their own distress. They are sthita prajna, equipoised. But if someone else is suffering, their heart melts. So our Jagannath Dev's heart melted. And what did he do? He sent Hanuman. Second pastime of Jagannath and Hanuman. He sent Hanuman Dev, Hanumanji, and said, go and save this devotee. He is very dear to my heart. And I am sick and he wants to see me. I want to see him, but the Pandas are not letting us. So go and tell him just to wait for a few days. And I will speeden up the days. Like instead of one day, I will have three days pass. So he just has to wait for 5 days. 15 days will pass. So Hanuman went to this devotee and like 30 foot. The devotee said, who are you? Said, I am Hanuman. Said, what happened? He said, just wait for another 15 days, the Lord will give you darshan. He said, is that what you have come here to say? Get aside, I want to come and see you, sir. I cannot wait 15 days to see the Lord. I want to see the Lord right now. My eyes are going to burst out of the socket without seeing my Lord. You see, so much hankering to see Krishna. So Hanuman tried explaining to him, okay, at least wait for 12 days. Wait for 9 days. Wait for 6 days. Wait for 3 days. He said, I won't wait even one day. I want to see Jagannath today. Hanuman said, okay, you go to the ocean then. I tried my best, but now you go. So now Jagannath, our Lord, our Prabhu, Neela Chale Amar Prabhu, Jai Jagannath. Jagannath was thinking, oh, Pandas failed. Even Hanuman failed. Now what to do? Let me change his direction. So if he walked south, he would reach the ocean. But Jagannath changed the geographical direction itself. So he thought he was walking south, but he walked 35 kilometers west. And the ocean is not coming. Walking, 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 no ocean. Then finally Jagannath couldn't hold himself. This devotee is walking 35 kilometers just to enter the ocean. Walking west, thinking, while coming I saw ocean was only here. What is wrong? You know, Jagannath can do anything. He is the supreme GPS.
Guru Parampara system.
GPS. He is the origin of the spiritual Guru Parampara system. So he can change all the GPS, all the coordinates. So this devotee Alwar started walking 35 kilometers west. And there, our Prabhu Jagannath manifested a four-handed form of Narayan to give darshan to this Alwar. He gave darshan to him, seeing his determination. And the Alwar just fell flat to the ground. And that four-handed deity of Narayan was originally called Alwar Nath, the lord of this Alwar. But with time, he's called Alar Nath. Alar Nath. When Chaitanya Mahaprabhu visited Alar Nath temple, you will read in Chaitanya Charitamrita. When Chaitanya Mahaprabhu went and saw Alarnath deity, whom did he see? Gopavesh Venuka Navakishor Natavar. He saw Shamasandar. He saw the Lord of his life. Because who is Chaitanya Mahaprabhu? The heart is Radharani. And Radharani sees Krishna only everywhere. In that deity of Alarnath, Chaitanya Mahaprabhu saw Shamasandar playing his flute. Gopavesh, having the dress of a gop, the cowherd boy. Gopavesh Venukar, in the hand playing the flute. Navakishor, very young and handsome Natavar, best among dancers. Gopavesh, Venukar, Navakishor, Natavar. This is what Chaitanya Mahaprabhu saw in Alarnath. And he fainted in ecstasy. Chaitanya Mahaprabhu would see Krishna everywhere. Even when he entered Puri, he would see the chakra on the top of the temple. And whom would he see? Gopavesh, Venukar, Navakishor, Natavar. He would see Krishna playing the flute in the chakra. He would see Krishna playing the flute in Alarnath. Pure Vaishnavas see Krishna everywhere. They see everywhere. They see Krishna in everything and everyone and everything in Krishna and Krishna in everything. Ramananda Raya was such an example. He saw Krishna everywhere. And Chaitanya Mahaprabhu tricked Ramananda Raya with this principle. Is everybody awake?
Yeah.
Because my narration shouldn't be like, I saw a dream, you know, Ramananda Raya. And then you realize you slept in the dream. Ramananda Raya, when he met Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, Chaitanya Mahaprabhu was sannyasi. But what did Chaitanya Mahaprabhu do? He tricked Ramananda Raya. He was sitting as sannyasi, but suddenly became Krishna. And then again became sannyasi. And then again became Krishna. And then again became sannyasi. And Ramananda Raya is saying, Pahila dekhila tumar sannyasi swarup. Eve toma dekhimo ishama goparup. First I saw you as sannyasi. And now I'm seeing you as Krishna. What's happening? He was actually changing. Chaitanya Mahaprabhu was changing his form. To show Ramananda Raya, this is me. But when Ramananda Raya caught, hey, first I saw sannyasi, now I'm seeing Krishna, again I'm seeing sannyasi, then Krishna, what's happening? What did Chaitanya Mahaprabhu say? Oh, you're Uttam Adhikari, you see Krishna everywhere.
There you go.
Stavara jangama dekhe na, dekhe tara murti, sarvatra hoye nija ishta deva spurti. Kaviraj Goswami is saying, Stavara, whether non-moving, Jangama, moving. Stavara Jangama Dekhena, not seeing. Dekhe Tara Murti, Sarvatra Hoye, Nija Ishtadeva Spurti. Whatever is in the heart of the pure Vaishnava, he sees that everywhere. So Chaitanya Mahaprabhu is Supreme Vaishnavi, Radharani, seeing Krishna everywhere. Alarnath also Krishna. Chakra also Krishna, and Jagannath also Krishna. This quality of seeing Krishna everywhere is fundamental for Uttam Adhikaris. We spoke about two pastimes of Jagannath with Hanuman. Now talking about the quality of seeing Krishna everywhere, we'll talk about a very beautiful, wonderful devotee by the name Dasya Bhauri. His name is Dasya Bhauri. Dasya Bhauri was such an exalted devotee. He saw Prabhu Jagannath everywhere. Jagannath, 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 Jagannath. Only Jagannath in this world, nothing else. And this is reality. Eka eka padartheshu trida bhavati vikshitai. Kunapa kamini mamsam yogi bhi kami bhishwadhi. Eka eka padartheshu trida bhavati vikshitai. If a lady is walking on the street, a beautiful girl is walking on the street, eka padartha, she is one personality, but trida bhavati vikshitai, there are three visions. Kunapaha, one person is a yogi. He's seeing her as a bag of, you know, all the worshipable things. Blood, etc. Bones and other things. Kunapaha. The yogi bihi, the yogi is seeing her as, oh, that spirit soul in a bag of matter. And kami bihi. A lusty man is seeing her as Kamini, object of enjoyment. And dog, Shwa, is seeing her as Mamsam, flesh. Yes? Eka eka padartheshu, only one product. Tridha bhavati vikshitai, kunapaha kamini Mamsam, yogi bhi kami bhi shwa bhi. Understand? So every object in this world can be seen on the basis of our consciousness. And when true consciousness, pure consciousness, Krishna consciousness is completely blossomed, what do you see everywhere? Stavara jangama dekhena dekhe tara murti sarvatra hoye nija ishta deva spurti. Pure Vaishnava sees only Krishna's hand in everything. So Dasya Bhavari was like this. One day he was very tired and very hungry. So he came home, told his wife, I am very hungry. I want to eat something. So what did she do? She had a pot. She had an earthen pot. And in that earthen pot, she filled it up with rice till the brim. And on the top of that, she put some shark. Shark is green leafy vegetables. But this was 5 days old. They were poor. So green had become black. So he was given rice with black shark in an earthen pot. What was the color of the earthen pot? Red. What was the color of rice? White. What was the color of shark? Eye of Jagannath. When Dasya Bhavari saw this, red earthen pot with white rice and black shark on the top, he started, Jai Jagannath, Jai Jagannath, Jai Jagannath, Swami Jai Jagannath. Hello! He was the person who came tired and hungry. He's looking at the food and he's doing kirtan. She asked him, what's wrong? He said, you are giving me the eye of the Lord. How can I eat this? She said, eye of the Lord? I thought I gave you rice with shark. He said, look, red, white, black. My Jagannath is following me everywhere. She was convinced he went crazy. She called some exorcists to remove the ghost out. They tried their best. The exorcist tried with the broom to remove. After 15 minutes he came out. Jai Jagannath, Jai Jagannath, Jai Jagannath, Swami Jai Jagannath. Another exorcist to remove the ghost out of him. Many people came. They all continued leaving with kirtan. And finally one person came and he said, yes, I found out the ghost. I said, who's the ghost? He said, he is the ghost who has big eyes, big smile. That ghost has entered his body. Then he told the wife, this is not any ghost. He is completely saturated with pure love for Jagannath. He is seeing Jagannath everywhere, inside out, upside down. Antar bahi yadi hari tapasata tat kim. If Krishna is there inside and outside, what is the need of any other tapasya? Remembering Krishna is the aim of all bhajan. Man mana bhava mad bhakto madhyaji mam namaskuru mame vaishyasi satyam te Pratijani prayoshime. Manmana, Krishna says. If the mind is absorbed, no problem. If hands and legs are moving but mind is not absorbed, we are gaining very less. So mind must be absorbed. Completely. The mantra and the mana, the mind, must be completely mixed together. Hare Krishna Mahamantra and Krishna Katha, Krishna Kirtan on one side, and the mana, the mind, completely mixed together. That the mind, wherever it goes, only Krishna Naam and Krishna Katha. So, he said, the solution now is, you take two earthen pots. And in one you give him rice, another you give him saag. Then no ice. Then he'll eat. Then she gave like that, and then he mixed and he ate. Now, Dasya Bhavi was very low class. So, the Pandas would never let him in. One day, Dasya Bhavi, he heard that one Brahmana is going to meet Jagannath, Prabhu Jagannath. So, he got some coconut. In fact, it's a long story. But they shot, the essence is that he got a coconut. He got coconut and then, in fact, let me just go back. Dasya Bhavi had a tailor shop. He was a tailor, tailoring shop. So he went to stitch for someone and the person had a coconut in his hand, in his house. So Dasya Bhavi looked at the coconut and he was doing everything with the coconut in his mind. He said, I want the coconut. And this person was very stingy. He said, okay, I'll give you the coconut if you do this for free. He said, I will do 10 such chador and whatever. I'll give you everything. But you just give me this coconut. So that person was happy. Dasya Bhavi was happy. He got the coconut home. Saw a Brahmana walking to Puri. So he gave it to him. And he said, please offer this coconut to Prabhu Jagannath. But don't give it to anyone. Just from the gate offer. And say that Dasya has given. Dasya Bhavi has given. And only if Jagannath takes it with his own hands, you offer. Don't give it to any panda. If Jagannath doesn't take it with his own hands, bring the coconut home. So Brahmana was laughing. He said, that ghost has still not left his body. So he went there. And the pandas were asking this Brahmana, okay, I'll take it. He laughed and he said, no, don't worry. Then from outside, he kept the coconut and he said, oh, Prabhu Jagannath! Deva Deva Jagannatha Prapannatri Vinashaka Trahimam Pundarikaksha Patitam Bhavasagare. Hey Prabhu Jagannath, your Dasya has given this coconut. This is for you. As soon as he said that, two hands came all the way from the altar out, took the coconut and went in. There's a real story in Puri of Dasya Bhavi. The Brahmana was completely shocked. He was thinking, what is this? Who has hands like this? He has such big hands, but he just stuffed all of that inside. When he needs, he just pulls it out and then pulls it out. See, he went to Dasya Bhavi, fell at his feet. He said, you are so fortunate. We are going there for darshan, but we just see the deity. For you, he is putting his hand out to take the coconut. Dasya Bhavi started crying and he fainted in ecstasy. That night in the dream, Jagannath appeared. Jagannath said, what can I do for you? Dasya Bhavi said, just make sure that we get to eat every day. Because we are so hungry and we are so poor that we don't get even food. Jagannath said, I feed everyone. I'll definitely feed you. Why are you worrying? Ananyas chinta yantomam yejana paryupasate tesham nityabhi yuktana yoga kshemam vahamyaham. Krishna has given this promise that those who do bhajan, those who worship him, those who chant his names, he will carry what they are having and he will give them what they lack. He will preserve whatever they have and he will give what they lack. When Krishna can feed elephants in the African jungles, tens and hundreds of kgs of rice every day, and he can feed ants 10 morsels of sugar every day, what to speak of those who do bhajan? What to speak of that? We don't have faith, therefore we have to lick the boot of so many boss in this world. We feel only he, oh, he is my Jagannath. This boss will feed me. But even if the boss doesn't feed, if we are doing bhajan, Krishna will feed. Krishna will, has to feed. When he is maintaining everyone, what to speak of maintaining his pure Vaishnavas? If we are doing proper bhajan with full faith, if we want something, the roof will break and Krishna will put it on your lap. Don't have to do anything. But we don't have faith. Durdaivam idrishamiha janina anuraga. So Dasi Bauri said, my Lord, I just need some sustenance. He said, don't worry, I will maintain you. What else? He said, my Lord, I want to see you, but I am not allowed inside the temple. What to do? Prabhu Jagannath said, I am present as the chakra. So every time you come for darshan, you don't even have to come in. Just look at the chakra and you will see me there. And we can talk. Don't worry. So Raghu said, very nice. His sleep was broken. He woke up that day, got 40 mangoes in a basket. And he took it to Puri. And then he saw the chakra. Whom did he see? Jagannath standing with big smile because his Dasya has come. Dasya Bhauri has come. So he kept the basket of mangoes on his head. And all the Pandas started fighting. No, we will take the basket inside. We will offer. Dasya Bhauri already has one experience before. No need. He has direct connection. Wireless communication. So he said, no problem. I don't need any of you. I can offer directly. They started ridiculing and laughing. How can he offer? He's outside. How can he offer? Dasya Bhauri said, now you watch what happens. He kept the basket on his head, looked at the chakra, and Jagannath was looking. He said, yes, ready. And he kept on the head and he told Prabhu Jagannath, all of these mangoes are for you. Take. And one by one, mango started disappearing. And the Panda started thinking, oh, definitely he's a magician. He's into black magic, some tantric siddhi. He's making things appear and disappear. They asked Dasya Bhauri, where are the mangoes? He said, Jagannath ate. He said, what do you mean Jagannath ate? They just disappeared. What's the proof? Dasya Bhauri said, Jagannath ate, he's satisfied, I am satisfied. Yasmin tushthe jagat tushtham. If Krishna is pleased, devotees are pleased, I am having so much supreme pleasure in my heart. That's because Jagannath is happy. The Pandas didn't believe. They went inside. They went into the deity room. And to the right were 40 mango seeds. And to the left were 40 mango peels. And Jagannath had mango all over his mouth. Those who are sincere, Prabhu Jagannath is ready to reciprocate. So much so that he is ready to come out as Rathyatra for those who can't enter. So for those who can't enter Puri, no problem. You have Alarnath. You have Chakra. And now you have Rathyatra. Now how many of you have been in Rathyatra, Puri Rathyatra? Oh, it is quite an experience. You have equal treatment there. Clerk, VP, both get same treatment. You're crushed in and out. How many of you have been in Mumbai local train? Okay, little. So you know what I'm talking about. Mumbai local trains are quite an experience. People enter the compartment even before the train comes. As if there is some Kohinoor diamond inside. And while leaving from the train, they jump even before the station has come, as if there is a tiger inside. This multiplied a million times is Rathyatra. It is the supreme humbling experience. You go with all, we can go with all our pride, come back humble. You know, like the sugar cane rod? Standing tall. And then you... it's thrown through the blades and the juice comes out. And not just that, after that the remains are thrown into the trash can. So Rathyatra can purify in and out only so that the juice of bhakti manifests. The British, they couldn't understand how so many millions and millions of people assembled in one place without prior advertisement. In the 1920s, 30s, 40s, they were thinking, with no internet, no announcements, no advertisement, no prior any newspaper cutting, nothing. He would think, how is it that so many millions and millions of people come to that same place one morning and leave that night? Who tells them? They were completely shocked. So they tried to stop it with different excuses that, oh, this is inhuman, this is risky, etc., etc. They tried their best to stop Rath Yatra in Puri. But by Prabhupada's mercy, it didn't stop in Puri, it started in London. It started in London. And how it started also, it's a very funny story. In the West Coast, Prabhupada gave Jagannath deities and he told the devotees, this is Jagannath. They didn't even have idea who this is. They were painting Jagannath. And one devotee asked another, who is this? He said, some cool hippie like me. No hair. Upmarket hippie. They had no idea who they are painting. So then Prabhupada had to introduce, this is Jagannath, this is Baladev, this is Subhadra. And he said, this is your Lord. You can do whatever you want with him. You can share everything with him. They said, okay. Next morning, Prabhupada came for Darshanarthi. Baladev is there, Subhadra is there, Jagannath Gaya. Missing. Prabhupada said, where is Jagannath? So the devotees said, we like to go on the beach for morning walk. We have taken Jagannath with us. So Prabhupada said, oh, this is not the way to take Jagannath. There is a proper legal way to do it. And that's how Prabhupada instituted and began Rath Yatra there. So when Prabhupada began Rath Yatra, people in Odisha, they were very annoyed. They said, you cannot take Jagannath out of Odisha. Prabhupada said, he is Jagannath, not Odianath. Jagannath means Lord of the universe, and to take him for a world tour is my business. So they tried to stop in Puri, but it started off in London. So Rath Yatra, Jagannath comes out to shower his mercy for those who don't want to take darshan also. It's like those who are sick, they go to the doctor. But if you're very sick, the doctor comes home. You call him up and he comes home. So all of us who are materially sick, we go and take darshan. But if you're so sick that we don't even want to take darshan, Jagannath comes out. As Rath Yatra. And there, with his big eyes, he's showering mercy on everyone. All the time showering mercy. This Rath Yatra is very significant. Because it represents a very deep mood. Krishna, who was living in Dwaraka, had left Vrindavan, gone to Mathura and gone to Dwaraka. And in Dwaraka, he was served by Rukmini and Satyabhama and other queens. But all the time, he would be chanting, Radhe, Radhe, Gopi, Gopi, Nanda, Yashoda, Surubhi, Kamadhenu, Subal, Shridam, Vasudam, Kinkini, Stoka Krishna, Mandali Bhadra, Madhumangal, Ujjwal, Arjun, Lavanga, all these names of Krishna's friends. So Rukmini and Satyabhama started thinking, we serve him all day and he's chanting all these names we have no idea about. What is it? What are these names about? They went to Rohini Devi. Rohini, the mother of Balaram, is the only common factor between Dwaraka and Vrindavan. So they went to Rohini Devi and said, can you tell us what this mystery is all about? Sometimes, during the day, Krishna standing in a threefold form. He has his crown and he's standing like this. And no flute, but he's just making his hand. During the day. And Satyabhama says, not just during the day, sometimes during night also. He's standing like that. Rukmini said, he sometimes tells me, the only reason I married you is because you remind me of Radharani. Who is this Radharani? Satyabhama said, what is this about Vrindavan? They don't feed him, so he has to steal. Sometimes he cannot steal, so he has to eat dirt. Then he has to walk through the forest without chappal. And then when poor guy he steals, they bind him to a wooden grinding mortar. What is this land? Rohini Devi started describing the glories of Vrindavan. And she said, this land of Vrindavan is so special that whatever you see in Dwaraka or Mathura all originates in Vrindavan. And she said, I want to speak about this. But if Krishna and Balaram hear this, they will leave all of you and run back to Vrindavan. So we have to keep Subhadra Devi outside as doorkeeper. So they kept Subhadra outside and told Subhadra, you can hear this katha, but make sure Krishna and Balaram don't come here. Because if they come, Dwarka will lose Krishna and Balaram and they will go back to Vrindavan. Subhadra Devi was standing outside, facing outward. But when the katha began, she was thinking, what is here? Everything is here. So she turned back and she was holding like this. And she's absorbed as Rohini Devi starts describing Vrindavan, starts describing the trees of Vrindavan, starts describing the birds of Vrindavan, starts describing the animals of Vrindavan, starts describing Yamuna, starts describing Giriraj Govardhan, starts describing the friends, Mother Yashoda, Nanda Baba, starts describing the Braja Gopis, starts describing Srimati Radharani. And Subhadra is just crying tears, listening to their selfless pure love. And she doesn't even realize to her right and left are Krishna and Balaram. She was supposed to guard them from hearing, but she was so absorbed that they are listening. And as she looks around, Krishna and Balaram have dilated eyes in shock of what they are listening to. Such ecstasy. They are reminded of Vrindavan in Dwaraka. Eyes have dilated, smiling up to the ear. The body is trembling. The hands have shrunken in. The legs have gone to the body. The hair have disappeared. Supreme shock. And Subhadra Devi, as she is listening, her hands get into her body. And for Krishna and Balaram, they shrunk inward. And at this point, Narad Muni, who's always there at the right time at the right place, he saw this and he said, I have seen this! I have seen this! I have seen this! And their ecstasy was broken and Krishna said, what? What have you seen? He said, I have seen how the Supreme Lord looks when he's in deep separation from his pure devotees. Krishna is standing threefold, but how he looks and what happens to him when he's in separation from his pure devotee, Srimati Radharani, this is how you look. And nobody in this world has seen this. Krishna was shocked because he was very embarrassed. It was like a inner house, very confidential moment. Imagine if a child is all alone in their room and looking at the mirror and dancing and stalking and singing, and suddenly the mother is looking. And the child looks, the face goes pink and red because they're caught. They thought nobody's seen. Where does this originate from? From this pastime of the Supreme Lord. When he was caught unaware that somebody is watching, he looked at Narad Muni and he said, what would you take to keep quiet? How much? Now Narad Muni is anyway floating in the waves of pure love. He said, oh, okay. The Lord's bribing me, you see. Okay. So that I don't tell anyone about this, I need something from you. He said, anything. Just keep it between us. Sure. Narad Muni said, the bribe that I need is that the darshan that I saw, the whole world should see. Whole world should see. Everyone in this world should see how you look when you are in separation from the purest devotees. You have to manifest with your brother and sister on this bhumandal and give shelter to the whole world. Let everyone see that you are bhakte bhyo bhakta vatsala, that you can be conquered only by pure love. And this is what happens to your peacock feather and threefold bending form with the flute when you are thinking of your pure devotees like Srimati Radharani. And to fulfill this desire of Narad Muni, Jagannath, Baldev and Subhadra manifested in this world. They manifested in Satya Yuga. But interestingly, which Satya Yuga that was, even the Puranas have no clue. The rough estimate is over 3.5 crore earthly years. Just like Krishna manifests in Dwapar, just like Ramchandra manifests in Treta, Krishna manifests in Dwapar, and Gauranga manifests in Kali, Jagannath manifests in Satya. He is Purushottam. Ramachandra is Maryada Purushottam. The Supreme Lord, when he follows rules and regulations. Krishna is Leela Purushottam. That Supreme Purushottam when he comes to perform pastimes. And Chaitanya Mahaprabhu is Prema Purushottam. Is that Purushottam who comes down to give Prema. But the origin, Prabhu Jagannath. So the Chardham that you find, Badrinath, is the Lord for Satya Yuga. Down, Ramnath, Rameshwaram. Lord Ram is the Lord for Treta Yuga. To the west, Dwarkanath, Krishna is the Lord for Dwapar Yuga. Satya is Badrinath. Treta is Ramnath. Dwapar is Dwarkanath. And Kali is Jagannath. You have a question. I thought Chaitanya Mahaprabhu is the Lord for Kali. Now you are saying Jagannath is the Lord of Kali. Chaitanya Mahaprabhu came down to give the simplest process, the holy name. But then, Ram Ram Hare Hare Krishna. Prabhu, you're sleeping, meditating. Holy name is sweet. Relishing. While chanting the holy name also we sleep. So Chaitanya Mahaprabhu's gift is also not accepted. Because he is giving the sweet of the holy name. But our pot of the heart has holes. So all of that is gone. All the kheer is gone. But Jagannath is more merciful. Why? Because he is coming down to give prasad. And you will never find anyone go. Everybody goes like this. So Chaitanya Mahaprabhu is merciful and Jagannath is merciful because he is giving prasada. So this aspect of Jagannath as Krishna in separation from Radharani is special. Chaitanya Mahaprabhu is Radharani in separation from Krishna. So both intimate forms of how Krishna looks in separation from Radharani, Jagannath, and how Radharani looks in separation from Krishna as Gauranga came face to face in Antelila Chaitanya Charitamrita. Both are having Vipralambha, separation. And therefore that land of Jagannath Puri is called Vipralambha Kshetra. The land of separation. Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, Radharani in separation from Krishna. And Krishna in separation from Radharani, Jagannath. And they are coming face to face. Chaitanya Mahaprabhu is going to embrace Jagannath. But thank God, there is a spiritual explosion and he faints. If he goes to embrace Jagannath, what will happen? Radharani in separation from Krishna is going to embrace Krishna in separation from Radharani. And the world cannot take so much sweetness. So fortunately, this explosion. And he faints. So in this way, Jagannath is very, very merciful. Supremely merciful. All Acharyas have their mutt in Jagannath Puri. Shankaracharya has mutt in Jagannath Puri. It's called Govardhan mutt. Ramanujacharya, Madhvacharya, Vishnu Swami, Nimbarkacharya, Padmanabha, Narahari Tirtha. And coming down to our Bhakti Vinod Thakur, Bhakti Siddhanta Saraswati Thakur. Bhakti Siddhanta Saraswati Thakur appeared in Purukshottam Kshetra, Jagannath Puri, as the mercy of Jagannath. And therefore he was called Bimal Prasad. Because in Jagannath Puri, you have a deity of Goddess Parvati called Bimala Devi. All the prasad that Jagannath gives out goes to her. So bhoga goes to Jagannath. Jagannath gives out prasad. That prasad goes to Bimala Devi. And she gives out maha maha prasad. So mahaprasad, prasad and mahaprasad. So puri pandas, if you go and tell them that we are giving mahaprasad, they will reprimand. Because they will say only puri has mahaprasad. You have prasad. Because you don't have Bimala Devi. So Jagannath gives prasad and that gives, and Bimala Devi gives mahaprasad. And that is taken by Vaishnavs. And if they leave behind remnants, it's maha maha prasad. Like that. So the blessing of Saraswati Thakur in the life of Bhaktivinoda Thakur was understood to be the mercy of Bimala Devi. Therefore he was called Bimal Prasad. That prasad, maha prasad. Mercy of Jagannath given to Bimala Devi, and Bimala Devi is giving to Bhaktivinoda Thakur. So it's called Bimal Prasad. So deep even in the name. Not like our name, Tittu, Chintu, Chotu, you know. Bimal Prasad, so deep. And our Prabhupada also, who time and again see the watch, wristwatch, and see what is the time for the next train to go to Puri from his home. And how merciful was our Prabhupada that at the age of 5, he organized his first ever Rath Yatra. Right from the age of 5, he wanted to take the eyes of the Lord outside. Because our Jagannath Prabhu has unique eyes. He doesn't have eyes like Krishna. Krishna's eyes are, you know, they have an elliptical shape. But Jagannath has round eyes. Why? Because his eyes are like magnifying glasses. They always see only good in everyone, and they magnify and see. And they want to see everyone at all times, because he's the Lord of the universe. So seeing everyone, round also. Upper planetary system, middle planetary system, lower planetary system. In 1965, when Prabhupada came, in 1966, ISKCON began, Prabhupada took Jagannath and he did the impossible of instituting Jagannath Rath Yatra in every major city of this world. So nowadays, we think it's just common to have Rath Yatra. But 50 years ago, Rath Yatra means only Rath Yatra in Puri. But we cannot go to Puri every year. So Prabhupada said, why not? We'll have Rath Yatra in Austin. And in that way, every city having Rath Yatra of its own. And in that Rath Yatra, everybody gets the glance of the Lord. Everybody gets the books of Prabhupada. They get the holy name. And they all get prasad amidst the loud chanting. Hare Krishna, 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 Hare Hare. Hare Ram, Hare Ram, Ram Ram, Hare. In this way, there are unlimited pastimes of Jagannath. We can go up to Mangal Arati. But unfortunately, we have other things to do. Therefore, remembering Prabhu Jagannath as the Lord of our lives and being ever grateful to the lotus feet of Srila Prabhupada for bridging that gap of the Lord of the universe to this citizen of the universe, that bridge of mercy. Lifetime after lifetime, we bow down with gratitude at the lotus feet of His divine grace, A.C. Bhaktivedanta.